Now, I know many people in this room, actually probably all of you in this room, are familiar with David's story, but it's one worth telling again for the folks at home. You see, David first joined UPS as a part-time employee when he was just 18 years old. Like many college students, he wanted to make some money after class so he could take his high school sweetheart out for a meal. As he stands here today, I think it goes without saying that he worked incredibly hard to get where he is today. But I mention David's story because there's no better example of UPS's dedication to its people. To me, his journey represents not only what the company stands for, but what it hopes to achieve here in Canada and, of course, around the world. While employees like David worked their way up the corporate ladder, UPS became a global leader in the industry. C'est d'ailleurs à cette époque qu'UPS a décidé d'étendre la portée de ses activités au-delà de ses frontières. En 1975, la compagnie américaine a fait son entrée sur le marché canadien et depuis, des milliers d'emplois ont été créés au Canada et partout dans le monde, une tendance qui se maintient encore aujourd'hui. When a company invests in its people and in growth, every employee can share that pride and success. At UPS, someone like David didn't doubt his place or his value to a growing enterprise. Organizations like UPS send a powerful message to their workers. Here, hard work pays off. These are exactly the kinds of companies that we want more of in Canada. Companies that value their employees and create better opportunities for working people to get ahead today and well into the future. That's why I'm so proud to welcome UPS's decision to invest more than $500 million in Canada, to add more than 1 million square feet in facility space across the country, and create more than 1,000 jobs in the coming years. En plus d'accroître sa présence montréalaise, la compagnie compte également investir dans les régions du Grand Toronto, dans d'autres régions de l'Ontario, ainsi qu'au Québec, en Colombie-Britannique, au Manitoba et en Alberta. D'ailleurs, dans mes débuts en tant que politicien, j'ai eu la chance de visiter la centrale UPS à Montréal. Ça a été une de mes premières visites en tant que jeune député et j'en garde un très beau souvenir. It's actually one of those little connections between us that in my very early days as a politician, I got invited to an event or a ceremony or an opening of some sort at the UPS facility in Montreal. And it was one of the very first times that I got to go and do an official event as I might have even still been a candidate. But it just felt so great for, you know, a big important company like UPS to actually care about inviting a little local politician over. So hey, I'm back today. I've done okay in the past few years, but so have you guys.
Ben, ces nouveaux investissements permettront de créer plus de 1 000 bons emplois pour les Canadiens de la classe moyenne. Des emplois pour les parents qui ont des enfants à nourrir et une retraite à préparer. Des emplois pour les jeunes ou les nouveaux arrivants qui veulent entrer sur le marché du travail ou encore pour ceux qui veulent changer de carrière. C'est une bonne nouvelle pour le Canada et surtout pour les Canadiens. Cela dit, une décision de cette ampleur ne se prend pas sur un coup de tête. Si un géant de l'industrie comme UPS choisit d'étendre la portée de ses activités en sol canadien, c'est parce que ses dirigeants ont confiance en notre potentiel de croissance et en l'avenir de notre pays. Ils ont confiance en ce que nous pouvons accomplir ensemble ici au Canada. De plus en plus, les entreprises internationales découvrent et saisissent les nombreux avantages de faire affaire au Canada. There are lots of reasons why more and more international companies like UPS look to invest and expand their footprints here in Canada. Unemployment is at its lowest rate in nearly 40 years, with close to 600,000 more Canadians working today than there were just 2 years ago. Not to mention, the Canadian economy was growing at the fastest rate of the G7 in 2017, and the OECD just further increased our growth forecast. For UPS, this means more customers to serve, more businesses to partner with, and higher demand for the solutions they offer here in Canada. Canada also has preferred access to a huge share of the global economy
through our comprehensive free trade agreements, including our two most recently completed deals, CETA with Europe and CPTPP with the growing economies of Asia, which will grant us preferential market access to nearly a billion more consumers through Europe and the Asia Pacific. We're in the process of renegotiating, updating, and improving NAFTA, in case you hadn't heard. It's going well. And we remain very confident that a win-win-win deal is not only possible, but likely. Canada and the United States together have built the greatest trading relationship the world has ever seen. Today is yet another example of the strong ties between our two countries. The Canadian business environment is not only stable, but predictable, setting up the right conditions for businesses to flourish and for workers to get ahead. And above all, Canadians are incredibly hardworking and skilled. They're not only ready, but able to take on the good-paying middle-class jobs and contribute to our economy. Our workforce is educated, open-minded, and diverse, qualities I know that appeal to a company like UPS and to its ethos. Companies like UPS know that to succeed, you need to innovate. And today's announcement is an example of that drive. Along with an announcement of growth and new jobs in Canada, UPS is committing to new sustainable practice standards. Aujourd'hui, UPS a également annoncé qu'à l'avenir, la moitié de sa flotte canadienne utilisera des carburants alternatifs. Cette nouvelle cible vise notamment à réduire les émissions produites par les systèmes de transport employés par la compagnie. Pour ce faire, UPS introduira de nouveaux véhicules au gaz naturel comprimé et se servira de nouvelles technologies pour réduire les distances parcourues et économiser du carburant. Comme les Canadiens, UPS sait que l'économie et l'environnement vont de pair. Il ne s'agit pas simplement d'effectuer une livraison à temps, mais d'atteindre cet objectif de façon durable et efficace. Nous partageons non seulement les préoccupations pour l'environnement, mais leur conviction de trouver des solutions concrètes qui peuvent être mises en œuvre rapidement. L'annonce d'aujourd'hui représente un pas de plus dans la bonne direction qui témoigne de l'engagement de la compagnie pour faire de notre monde un monde plus vert. My friends, the future looks bright. Today's announcement is a vote of confidence in Canada and mostly in Canadians. In fact, it's also the second example of foreign companies choosing Canada to expand their businesses and create jobs this week alone. On Monday, our Minister of Innovation, Science and Economic Development, Navdeep Bains, announced a nearly $400 million investment in Canada by way of the Encore project that will secure 4,000 new jobs in Quebec and Ontario and maintain 2,000 more by developing the new 5G network that's going to allow companies like UPS and small businesses across the country to better coordinate through technology and develop the kinds of apps and infrastructure and technology that are going to serve us all for decades to come. This is proof that our plan to grow the economy and create better opportunities for Canadians is working. Companies are taking notice, and so are Canadians. So once again, I want to thank you all for making the trip and for choosing Canada for the very first managerial conference that UPS holds every year outside of the United States. And we are very much looking forward to the next partner and to the next chapter in this wonderful 43-year partnership. Merci beaucoup, mes amis. Merci encore.